Oh.
Thrive under evil and work ease out of pain. See, every moment that you've held inside of yourself, you have regained and renamed itself to a newer dichotomy. See, everything I say is coming from inside of me, and I'm speaking nothing but honestly. And I am dreaming of gasoline-dripping infernals painted on the side of a Grecian urn. Heat to burn, heat to make gunpowder out of my dead bones. See, when death comes, he'll be cordial. And even if your ending turns out to be horrible, and even if the pyramids align with the oracles, the prophecy that I send to you is make money and get it for your prophecy. See, I chopped this story a moment so I could inert my scattered being into the dirt. So we all will turn to dust and return to the gaping horizon, skipping off across the water for infinities. Meditative nirvanas only interest me, like a loan taken out against my happiness. So I make like Michael Phelps through all of this filth that I felt in his softened silk, honey, oats, and milk that is diffused from Paradise Lost. I hear nothing but mechanical moans of the abandoned animals. See, this morning I woke up in Eden again. 7 o'clock this evening, even when the evening news was beginning to spew its concocted stew of lies with broken rules, I gassed my car and broke the rules. Kind of like Kardashian broke the internet, I broke the noose. See, I say when I woke up, I decided to pick whose shoes I'm in and shoes I'm stuck in. And these weathered feet, I've attached the soles to the soles of my heel because I just want this pain inside of me to heal. See, pain has again established residency and has no desire to leave. So I've been hanging on to this Edenic tree like a winter leaf, not knowing when to leave. I am nothing but leftovers for shepherds, misguiding the flock forward. Disruption breeds Benjamin Buttons, reversing into birth as if I was no longer pushed but in pull from suction. And we must look at the origins of birth. To be born is to be stitched into a universal fabric. It's a cooling fabric woven with billions of loose threading. And those busy fibers that negotiate their patterns with each other bears a distinct texture, and we begin to crinkle into existence. But to exist is to race to our death, is it not? And to succumb to the magnetic pull that inches us to our finality. What do we make of that vacuous space in between birth and death? How do we feel the fleeting occupancy that we call life? Isn't life just a white flash of existence that will eventually pale to a muted glow? We are dead eternally longer than we are alive, so what is it to be born? To be born is to just be. From birth, we are unknowing of our place in the universe. We just breathe, indulge in the twinkling and the twinges of emotions, delight in the rash irritations of discomfort. There is never a more beautiful time to be than when you are born, because the newborn is new to how the world works, swaddled in a blanket of innocence. And for that brief time, time stops and life is a mere suspension of gravity. There is no weight on the world to be felt on those supple shoulders. One does not know who they are and what they stand for, what there is to be known. It's a beauteous ignorance that we lose with each passing day. But in those wee early days, they are unrepulsed by the darkness. See, the newborn just clings onto what it can attach to, like a suspended dewdrop clinging to the edges of the morning grass. They moistly rest until their broken heart's unbroken suspension breaks, and they free fall into an unavoidable collision with the real world. I guess we all just hope to make a splash within this fabric and can only imagine what those days before the life once held. Light is born. Thank you.